he didn't enjoy playing it. He wasn't having fun playing it. I don't understandably blame him. So.
Oh yeah.
So
look, I stopped playing it.
But Scat, being the Mega Man, you know, resident Mega Man man, he actually now Scat, and towards the end of his Smash 4 career, played so many characters. Like, it was like pick a character,
yeah,
and then play it well and at a decent level. He just had a really deep understanding of the game. Looks like we're going to be seeing his Mega Man here. I'm a huge fan of his Mega Man play.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, he's basically like family. Smash 4, we were part of the same Smash 4 crew. So
oh, it was nice.
So it's cool to see that. So we got some team heavies.
Oh, yeah.
Ganondorf and Bowser. I didn't even know that Dusk had a Bowser. Ganondorf, actually. I'm sorry. I didn't know that Dusk had a Ganondorf. I thought we'd be seeing Roy.
Yeah. Guess you've been labbing.
Yeah. So here we go. Mega Man and Diddy. We're going to get right into it here. Let's see. Doubles, obviously very different from like singles and squad strikes in the nature of how it's played. It's basically an entirely different game.
Oh, yeah.
And it's kind of an art form.
Oh, he's going super hard for that. Yeah,
he's going deep for it.
He's going deep. Oh.
Not afraid to take the risk. The forward smash
catching Diddy. Oh, and Scat gets the spike. That was real nice.
That was clean. So already down one stock, and they're looking really solid now. Player one and Scat looking like they have a pretty solid lead at the beginning here.
Yeah.
Dust obviously not taking very much percent, but characters like Bowser and Ganondorf obviously can get KOs very early.
Of course.
It's looking like a hard read will close out either of their stocks right now.
Yeah, exactly. But being quick like with Mega Man and Diddy, it's going to be pretty hard to get them since they're so nimble.
Yeah, and actually Mega Man's actually technically into a nice up tilt coming from Scat there. Mega Man's technically kind of like a heavy character. I think his weight got nerfed a little bit, but he was heavyweight in the past.
Oh my goodness, Scat with the S-guard. That was nice. I'm not sure.
But they're definitely, yes, getting mileage right now. Big play down to his last stock already. It seems like this double heavy team, which is also going to mean combo food.
When
it gets down to these, when it gets down to last, like, you know, when it's like a 2v1 situation, it's going to be really hard to do anything.
And then
Warlock kick actually closing out the stock on Scat. Player one still holding on to all three stocks. Doing a great job here.
He's trying to pretty much get Bowser.
He wasn't able to get it this time. So big play going to safely recover to the stage, but at 102%, it's not much longer for this world.
Exactly. And they couldn't close that out. Close out Scat with a 2v1. Oh,
good
nice
tech from Scat. Nice forward tilt from Dusko. Going to push Scat away a little bit. Going to get some damage. Player one finally dropping his first stock.
Yeah.
And Dust down to his last stock. It's looking like this is going to be it here soon.
Yeah, so it's looking nice.
Big play, standing at 163%. It will take nothing short of a miracle to see if they can bring it back.
It's just the heavies, they can't hit nothing right now. They're missing attacks. Yeah.
I don't think that these characters synchronize. It's based on what we're seeing this game. They're synchronizing very well with each other.
Oh, okay, here it goes. At this point, this is where I just jump off the cliff.
I mean, it's brackets. You can never.
There come a combo.
Yeah. They're looking for for the dare. Player one going to make it back to the stage. Very nice recovery. That Rocket Bros. Nice.
Scat with the leaf cheese.
Ooh. Down smash. Nice spot dodge there. Going to get some damage. Don still trying to, or Dust rather. Oh, got the fair coming up. And managed to recover.
Wow.
I cannot believe I thought he was dead.
I thought he was gone.
That was nice. The magnet hands, man. The magnet hands.
And Dust is just flying for his life right now.
Nice. And we got the peanuts coming out there. Ooh, but it caught Scat out of a back air and the forward smash. And that was a very weakly charged sports match.
Yeah,
it's always so crazy to see like
how strong it is.
It's
yeah,
so, strong,
it's so much knockback.
I want to see how stocks get depleted with like a fully charged one. I want to get read forward smash. And I want to see that full Mega Buster. You know, it's like Mega Man X looking Mega Buster. You know, so
to be honest, I'd rather have Mega Man X in this game than the club.
I think most people probably would have preferred that. But
yes.
I mean, I like Mega. Like, I think he turned out okay in this game. I think that they stayed very true to Mega Man in general.
The classic, yeah.
Yeah, the classic. I mean, I think they did the character justice and porting him to the Smash universe.
Oh, yeah. At least we have him, right?
Yeah, at least we have him. Can't complain.
Then we got Persona 5 coming.
Yeah, we got Joker coming soon. Did you actually have any experience playing Persona 5?
Nope.
Oh, no? Okay, well, you're probably not very hyped for the character. I, you know, sunk about like 120 hours within like a week's time
into
Persona 5.
Oh, dang.
So it was definitely – I like beat the game and then like same night started my second playthrough.
Oh, dang. So you can't wait to –
I'm not particularly excited for the character. Like, I want to see his kit first, then I'll be excited. See how you, like, I like Joker.
Yeah.
As a character, like, I love Persona.
Yeah.
So, or at least, no, Persona 5, that's my first one.
Yeah.
So, I want to see what his kit's like, and then I'll be hyped. When I see the kit, that's when I'll be like, I might, you know, that's when might be like, buy Inkling or something We'll see.
When that DLC actually coming down?
I don't know. Like, you know, if you bought the DLC pack, it's projected out till next year, like February of 2020.
Wait, what?
Like, it's projected into February 2020 for, like, all the characters.
No, I'm just saying the next one coming out.
Oh, we don't know.
He's going to be part of the next one that's coming out.
The next character that we'll be seeing first is Piranha Plant, and I believe that's on January 31st.
January 31st?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Piranha Plant, a character that no one was expecting. It looks like we're going to see Dust going to be played. Both are going to. Actually, no, we're only seeing one character switch. Inkling, which is speculated to be the Devil's character. Inkling is speculated to be the Devil's character because of the ink mechanic.
Oh, that makes sense. Because he's doing more damage or whatnot. Yeah,
so now they're actually going to have a little bit more mobility. Dusk, you know, Ganon didn't necessarily do bad. He was getting some things. Like, he was obviously surviving for a while.
He was.
I just think that the two characters, the two heavy.
The heavy wasn't working.
It just wasn't working.
Yeah.
And they were, you know, sort of combo food, and they weren't able to get anything going.
Exactly.
I think that. Because
it was always an instant.
Yeah, a good switch.
And let's see if Scott's going to get these two double. Oh, nice.
Nice parries. Nice. He's hearing parries everywhere. Good stuff. Oh, down smash coming out there. Dusk already dropping his first stock. I think what we're not really seeing is that player one is actually doing a really good job of controlling the stage.
Oh, they're doing a fantastic job.
Obviously, player one sort of controlling the center stage and, like, you know, sort of zoning with his bananas. He's always been so good at the bananas.
But
we're seeing stocks drop quicker here. Player one has already dropped his stock. I can't tell if Scat's actually dropped his stock yet because his thing's right in front of me. So they're actually significantly doing better. Definitely the Inkling switch is better. Another stock claimed.
Spike.
That was clean from Dust there, and so now they've got a lot to come back from. This is pretty far.
Especially Ganondorf being heavy, so it's going to take a minute for him to be pretty much KO'd.
Big play, surprisingly, Inkling being the sort of the stock tank here, but it's a, you know, support character.
Of course.
So it makes sort of sense, you know.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Because for those unaware that are watching, you know, you can share stocks if you run out of your stocks. So holding on, like, so big play holding on to the stocks as long as he's doing is very important. And if he can manage to keep this up, Scat, I think, was probably looking for a back air there.
Oh,
but,
yeah.
You know, didn't get it because that was looking like a punch situation. Nice forward kick. Scat already at KO percent here.
Oh, ooh, nice tech from nice tech. Scat
always very technical player, good presence of mind to do that, clean tech.
And right now they're just getting walled out.
And there goes the forward air. Going to close out the stock on big play, but that's their first stock. You know, ooh, a splat bomb catching Scat off stage. Dong looking for a back air coming out.
At that situation, it's pretty much 50-50.
Yeah, so Dusk actually doing a really great job of covering Ganondorf's cover so much better. He was going pretty low there, and Scat really great at edge guarding, really knows how to use his tools. Obviously having the time to get an up air, like, you know, back in the past, if you up air down there from Ganon, you weren't coming back up.
Exactly.
So it's nice to see so many viable characters in this game. It makes me really excited.
It's so many. It's pretty much got the matchups are just ridiculous. You got each fight's like, all right, what can he do? Because it's like 70 characters. Okay. So it's going to take a minute for each character. Oh, man.
Another fair closing out of stock. But
did they buff that fair?
I do believe that the fair is a little bit stronger. Force match coming out. Ooh,
nice.
Big player not able to hold onto his stock as long. Player one actually doing a pretty good job for both of his stocks. Both of his stocks got closed out early. I think that the adaptation was very good there. Obviously, it's going to be a 2v1 scenario very soon.
They really need to take out player one.
With the bananas gone and the Diddy fair gone.
Exactly.
Well, I say Diddy fair gone, but Inkling has a very similar fair.
Uh-oh.
And this is it's going to be really bad. They could really turn it around right here in this moment.
Oh, and he finally took out the...
So it's a 2v1 scenario.
Ooh, he wasn't ready.
He wasn't ready. But they're going for the edge guard here.
Right now, Scott's fighting for his life. If he can cluster this out. Oh!
Nice splat bomb. Caught his teammate a little bit, but that's okay there in this scenario. I think it was the trade was worth it. They got stage control.
They go for the slosher. Nice. Yeah. You can't really do it at that point. That was a really nice play.
So now it's looking 1-1. Definitely.
That character switch actually made a big difference.
Significant difference.
They weren't just getting bodied.
Yeah, definitely. And the big play's first stock was phenomenal in how long he survived up to like 160-something.
Exactly.
161, 80, I think, percent off his first stock. And then Don on his he lost his first stock fairly early, but he survived up to about 143.
Exactly.
So they had some really good longevity in their stocks, and they were closing out stocks early because obviously, you know, Ganon – very powerful heavyweight character. So it worked out perfectly.
It seemed like that might be the, I guess, the goal for the next in the upcoming doubles, having a support character and a heavy character just to close out stocks and also to keep stocks going.
Yeah. The only thing, and it's going to be really hard to do, to be honest. Like, I don't know. Like, it might be overestimating Inkling's ability is really getting usage of that ink.
Yeah.
Obviously, there was ink. Like, the splat bombs did do some ink. We're not seeing fully inked characters close. Yeah. We're not seeing, like, people get deleted at, like, 20%.
Exactly.
But
It's still making an effect.
It makes an impact.
Oh, yeah.
Because if you're behind, it gives you the ability to make a lead.
Comeback, exactly. Yeah. And not only if a person, like, is inked up and your opponent, let's say your opponent has a whole bunch of ink, but you have rage, you can also close us, and especially if you're heavy, you can pretty much end them pretty quick.
Yeah, you know, actually, now that I think about it, moves that we have not seen a lot of coming from Big Play's Inkling in that first set, we didn't see any, I don't think we saw any roller used.
No, I guess he was afraid of hitting his own opponent.
Teammate, you know, he could have hit his own teammate because, you know, team attack is on, right?
Exactly.
So that could have been a big thing. I think that some of those risks could be calculated and accepted because when you roller your opponent, they're going to town and city C. I think that's a smart pick.
Big one, just came back from Smashville, right?
Yeah, they came back from Smashville.
And what's the difference? Is it just the bigger box? Or
well, I believe Town and City has a smaller blast zone, to my knowledge.
Really?
I could be wrong. I would have to double check that. I think Town and City has smaller blast zones. They also have, like, a different platform mechanic. Like, the triplats come in for a little bit, and then they leave, and it can, like, stretcher you out if you land on this triplat, kill you. There's very, very many an upset back in Smash 4 days.
I bet. So right off the bat.
So, all right, player one recovering pretty safely there, but already at 81%.
My goodness.
And it looks like they're, and I don't know if this is their strategy or whatnot, but they are looking, it seems like player one seems to be the target here.
Yeah, I guess they're getting really tired of those bananas, slipping them up.
Yeah, I mean, Diddy's a lightweight character. Oh, yeah, bananas are annoying.
It's
super
annoying.
That's fighting that character.
So he said, let's delete this monkey first, and then we can handle the Mega
Man. He used to have two bananas in Brawl. You know what that feels like?
Oh,
he killed his own teammate. Oh, and he tried to get him back there, the win box, or the hitbox on the up B. So unfortunate that he killed his own teammate that way.
So it looks like they're taking care of neutral right now. They're just boxing him out.
Look at it, we got two 1v1s right there. But, good presence of mind. The Big Play to see, hey, my teammate's struggling. I need to get in there and help him out.
Exactly.
And he tried to go ahead and follow up.
And look at Ganador spamming the Force Smash, trying to get a pick off.
I think he inked up his partner more than he inked up Diddy, but it's unfortunate. Ooh, good parry coming out there.
Oh, and let's see if...
He
went for the hard read.
Going for now is not the time.
In that situation, he should have just helped his teammate out on that.
He didn't need the ink. But he wasn't all completely out. We're seeing a lot more parries coming out. I'm starting to wonder if these are accidental parries or intentional. We're seeing them come out now. It's getting pretty good. Ooh, nice.
And
jab. He killed with a jab.
A jab? Are you serious? Did he that light?
Ooh, and he's about to kill his teammate. So they reclaim the stock there that he took from him.
Oh,
wow. He got scared.
He wasn't confident in that. And there was a fair.
He tried to drift a little bit. I think he didn't want to go all the way to get caught by a dare from Scat or like a metal blade or back air.
He tried to play it safe, but
he tried to play it safe, mix it up just a little bit, but took too long. So it's unfortunate that he lost the stock that way.
And Scat still has three stocks. Wow.
Yeah, Scat, and only at 97%.
Yeah.
So right now, Don, or Dusk rather, who is on.
Scat's
last stock.
Oh,
it's looking pretty rough.
Man, he already lost two stocks already. Wow.
Yeah, it's like I actually didn't even catch how he lost. Well, I saw he lost a stock to his, teammate. I'm not sure how the second stock got closed out. I think we're Asuzi focusing on the big play there, and already lost the stock. Immediately going to share stock, which you got to do, and then the up tilt comes out. So now it is Dust all by himself.
Oh wow.
Good. I believe that was that a nair that caught him?
Yeah, that was a nair. Scat still at three stocks.
And that was just the epitome of edge guarding there. Great stuff. Great adaptation. It was a really good set to see.